Neurosciences Paris-Seine laboratory is ideally located at the heart of Paris, on the Pierre and Marie Curie campus of Sorbonne University, enabling a close relationship between university, students, and research laboratories. Over the centuries, the now called Pierre and Marie Curie campus has been occupied by the Abbaye Saint-Victor in 1109, a center dedicated to knowledge and the famous library, the Halle aux Vins in 1665, the first wine trade market of Paris, and the Faculté des Sciences in 1894, where the novelist Marie Curie conducted a part of her research. In 1959, the Faculté des Sciences expanded and the Pierre and Marie Curie campus was inaugurated. In the following years, many neuroscientists joined, like René Couteau, known for the first synapse imaging using electronic microscopy, the Fessard and the Buzer, founders of French neuroscience, known for their contribution to the neurophysiology. From this legacy, in 2014, the Neuroscience Paris-Seine Laboratory was created as part of the big Institute of Biology Paris-Seine. It gathers today 13 research teams with over 170 scientists as well as 50 PhD students and postdocs working in an international atmosphere. Several platforms are present on site, ranging from cellular imaging to behavioral experimentation. The Neuroscience Paris-Seine research community aims at studying the brain in normal and pathological conditions using an integrative approach. We try to understand the role of different brain structures and how they are interconnected together anatomically and functionally in order to allow complex behaviors. By taking advantage of cutting-edge techniques and multi-scale analysis, our research areas range from the molecular level to clinical tests and biotech companies. So let's take a closer look at what is done at our laboratory. Marie-Charlotte is studying cellular and molecular dysfunctions at the origin of psychiatric disorders, including drug addiction and depression. She combines in situ detection of protein-protein interactions from mice and human brains with custom-made interaction disruption strategies in behaving preclinical mouse models. Esther is trying to understand how the control of blood perfusion by cortical neurons is altered in Alzheimer's disease. To address this issue, she uses vascular imaging and optogenetics in a mouse model of Alzheimer's disease. Nolan and Susan are investigating the effects of exposure to endocrine-disrupting chemicals on male and female reproductive behaviors. They are using behavioral and proteomic analysis to identify neural biomarkers for health risk assessment. Flavio studies the genetic basis of autism spectrum disorder and the underlying pathophysiological mechanisms. He is investigating how the absence of a gene affects social behavior and testing the efficacy of potential treatments in transgenic mice. Genciana and Charlotte are working on a neural basis of special cognition in mice by using neural tracing, neural inactivation, and electrophysiology during real-world navigation tests. In parallel, other team members are doing the equivalent in humans, providing new tools to analyze special cognition impairments in patients. From this fundamental research, several biotech companies have emerged, offering innovative therapeutic solutions for many brain diseases. So come and learn more at the FENS Forum.